Taking a snapshot of a population at a certain point in a time is called cross-sectional study. Cross-sectional studies measure the prevalence of disease and are often called prevalence study. This study begins with defined population and we take a part of a population as a sample. After that, we collect data on both exposure and outcome. There are four possible outcomes in cross-sectional study. Number first, exposure positive and disease positive. Number second, exposure negative and disease positive. Number third, exposure positive but disease negative. Number last, exposure negative as well as disease negative. Each subject can be categorized into one of the four possible outcomes. Cross-sectional studies are relatively easy and inexpensive to conduct and are useful for investigating exposures that are fixed. But in a cross-sectional studies, temporal relationship between exposure and onset of a disease cannot be established, and recall bias is a major disadvantage of cross-sectional study. Now let's talk about cohort study design. This study begins with defined population who are free from diseases and classified into subgroups according to their exposure status. Then whole cohort is followed up to see how subsequent development of new cases of a particular disease in a cohort differs between groups with and without exposure. Cohort studies are often called prospective studies as the investigator looks forward for the outcomes. In a cohort study, natural history of a disease can be established as cohort study take healthy people as their starting point, and it is possible to examine wide range of outcomes, and it is the direct measurement of incidence of a disease in a cohort. Cohort study takes long follow-up period, so loss to follow-up is major disadvantages in cohort study design. Now let's talk about case control study design. Case control studies are relatively simple study to investigate causes of the rare diseases. It begins with people with disease, that means cases, and people without disease, that means controls. It is also known as retrospective study, where an investigator is looking backward from disease to possible cause, and exposure status of a cases is usually determined after the development of a disease through direct questioning. In this study, odds of exposure among cases is compared to odds of exposure among controls, which is called odds ratio. If odds ratio is greater than 1, suppose 8, exposure subjects are 8 times more likely to develop disease than non-exposure one. If odds ratio is less than 1, then it represents protective factors. However, recall bias is a major disadvantage of case control study, and selection of appropriate control is necessary while conducting case control study. Thank you so much for watching this video and subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to hit that notification bell so that you get notified whenever we upload a new video. Thank you.